I want to give you guys the same motivation I have. And I want you guys to grow to be successful with me. I don't want to just be successful by myself. I want my message to grow other people and make other people successful. Don't ever believe that the lack of funds is the reason why you're not being successful. This is not true. The lack of belief is why you're not successful. Every single human being on this earth is a walking million-dollar check. And our belief in ourselves, our grind, our true grit. Every morning you wake up and you look in the mirror, I want you to look in that mirror and I want you to tell yourself that I am special, I am great, and I am phenomenal. My goal, my individual goal, is to become one of the best speakers of all time. But I know I have so much work to do. While they sleep, I must work. While they party, I must grind. While they procrastinate, I must go after my future with a relentless effort. Growing up in the projects of Pontiac, Michigan, I realized two things. I realized that I won't make it if I believe that this is my reality for the rest of my life. I had to realize that all the knowledge and my gifts were already placed inside of me at birth. All I have to do is fine tune. All I have to do is keep working on this craft every single day. And I can be successful. We got to make this decision in our life today, kings and queens, that we will not be ordinary. We will be great. We will be kings. We will be royal. We live in a world where people believe everybody is out to get you. But I'm telling you now, some people is just out to love you. We're going to forget about the people who left us. And we're going to focus on the people who loves us. We're going to focus on the people who believe in us. Because you have greatness inside of you.
You know, negative thoughts and how you feel about yourself, they don't die. They come back once you stop doing the maintenance work on your mind. Negative thoughts are like weeds. You can't kill weeds. You can hold them down for a minute. But once you stop doing the things to overpower those negative thoughts, because we've been taught to dislike ourselves, that if I said to you, Tom, you can't do this show. You just don't have what it takes. You have a face that only a mother could love, Tom. You can't do this. Then MIT did this study that somebody else has to come along and say, Tom, don't pay any attention. You can do it, Tom. You can do this. Don't listen to him. You can do this. Listen to me, Linda. You can do this. 17 times to neutralize that one time. Listening to motivational messages, going to seminars and workshops, spending time quietly listening to the still small voice within. Who am I really? Is this really me? Am I giving my best? Am I just reflecting what's around me? Because all of these various things affect how we show up in life. And so having a strategy to continuously find ourselves reaching higher. There's a real you. Richard Wright said it best. He said, the impulse to dream has slowly been beaten out of me through the experiences of life. So when you live in a culture that is designed to destroy your sense of self, where you are marginalized, where you have a feeling of being hopeless and powerless, and you're terrorized, now you have to operate within the constraints of the dominant society and the things that they've created for you. And it's a challenge to see yourself beyond that and to work to get outside of that even after those laws have changed, because that has become so much a part of you, you unconsciously operate within the parameters of what has been put in place. Like you're driving on the expressway, the 405, and you'll get off on an exit that you weren't going in that direction, but you unconsciously did it because you've done it so many times that many people, because they're not making a conscious, deliberate, determined effort to think outside of what life has thrown at them, they end up doing the same thing over and over and over again. Einstein said that thinking that has brought me this far has created some problems that this thinking can't solve. And so through relationships, through reading, through studies, through goals and dreams beyond your comfort zone, it allows you to begin to live out of your imagination as opposed to out of your history. That they have to expose themselves to something that will give them a different vision of themselves. And in addition to that, they have to put themselves in a community of what I call OQP, only quality people. A gentleman who dramatically transformed my life, I was a junior at Booker T. Washington High School in Miami, Florida. And I went in his class looking for another friend. And he said, go to the board and work this problem out for me. I said, sir, I can't do that. He said, why not? I said, I'm not one of your students. He said, do it anyhow. And the other kid started laughing, saying, he's Leslie. He's DT. And he said, what's DT? His brother is smart, but he's the dumb twin. And I said, I am, sir. And he came from behind his desk and he pointed at me and said, don't you ever say that again. Someone's opinion of you does not have to become your reality. And he taught me three things. He said, if you want to become successful in life, young man, he said, number one, you got to change your mindset. He said, you don't get in life what you want, you get in life what you are. Number two, practice OQP, only quality people. You earn within $2,000 to $3,000 of your closest friends. I found that out. I left all my broke friends. I said, y'all gotta go. Because I used to be so broke, I'd pass a bank and trip the alarm, you know? And the third thing he said, develop your communication skills, because once you open your mouth, you tell the world who you are. He said, those are three major things that you want to work on that will liberate you from living in Liberty City, living in poverty in Overtown. It will help to escape out of where you are right now, because I see you watching me and I know you want more. I can see the hunger in your eyes. One, self-awareness, where you constantly, every day when I get up, I read. I get up and there's a scripture I love, because all things work together for good for those who love God and for those who are called according to His purpose. And so I meditate on that and I visualize myself doing some good stuff in the planet. The next step is not only self-awareness, but the next thing is self-approval, that you have to have a program that will increase your sense of self, reading, doing good work, volunteering, constantly looking for ways in which you can improve all the dimensions of your life, being a better father, being a better husband, a wife, or being a better person, because we want to have a holistic approach to life. Because if your achievements outgrow your sense of self, you will unconsciously engage in self-destructive behavior. And we're witnessing that now on a national level. You get hungry by finding something that's you. I believe that all of us are born unique, but most of us die copies. You gotta find out what is it that turns you on, what resonates with you. So the key to that hunger-driven life is a heart-centered life. I didn't do what I'm doing for years because of my programming, because of the culture in which I was raised in. I would see other people with degrees and PhDs and MBAs and credentials I don't have, and I convinced myself I couldn't do it. But Mr. Washington, on that day, we became friends, and he taught me not only someone's opinion of you does not have to determine your reality. He said that you have to work on yourself and you have to have an unstoppable attitude and no excuse is acceptable, and you've got to make it a priority, a non-negotiable in your life, and hold a constant vision of what it is you want to achieve. See it accomplished and go all out. Find a way to win in spite of the setbacks, in spite of the disappointments, in spite of your failures. I tell people when I'm giving presentations, you will fail your way to success. I have a saying, is life knocks you down, try and land on your back, because if you can look up, you can get up. And so those experiences of going after goals that's beyond your comfort zone and having relationships that will challenge you and surrounding yourself with coaches and mentors who can take you to a place within yourself that you can't go by yourself, because you can't read the label when you're locked in the box. And so those experiences, they challenge you to go to that next level and continue to move forward in your life, doing new and exciting things that eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor has entered the heart of mankind what God has in store for you when you live a hard-centered life, deciding that you're going to live a life that will outlive you. You're going to live a life that counts, a life that will build a legacy and change the planet. You know, Horace Mann said, we should be ashamed to die until we've made some major contribution to humankind.